1-876-58-22-704. Tune in and be blessed. Our YouTube channel is Hot Wax Promotion. Please subscribe, comment, like and share.
Check out our live broadcast 24/7 at Zeno.fm/radio/Hot Wax Blazing FM. Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube and all digital platforms. We are giving voice to the voiceless, changing lives by turning darkness to light. Join us today.
Greetings to you, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, and all digital media family.
So I stood up and I watched them from afar.
Rising radio station, Hot Wax Blazing FM, giving a voice to the voiceless with a spiritual awakening.
We have immorals gone up, except a wickedness, them cultivating evil, them farm.
We can be contacted at the email of hotwax@gmail.com.
Welcome to Hot Wax Blazing FM. Of course, your real revolutionary radio. And of course, today we have, of course, a very special guest in this segment that we call, of course, Community Scope. We're going to be welcoming our special guest right here on Hot Wax Blazing FM across the world. And of course, before we do so, we want you to take a listen up of this song.
Because of them poor struggling, figure the boat job, and I need repair to the Dembo. No, Mr. Slim Food, they really are. Because of them poor struggling, figure the boat job, and I need repair genocide and war. So I stood up and I watched them from afar. Adams. Hey, my people, where have their morals gone? X amount of wickedness, them cultivate evil, them farm. Where have your morals gone? Babylon, Jah I go hit you with a storm. Where have your morals gone? X amount of wickedness, them cultivate evil, them farm. Where have your morals gone? Where have your morals gone? Because of them press people, want them know them morals standard. Inoculating the place with evil, embracing the thing them ever. It hurt me heart, tear me soul, make the rico feel sad. They must get a beating from the Almighty God. Pray for the leaders of the world and them constitutions. All them a do across division and confusion. Me come to the youth, them right me up on the father mission. Righteous come together, rebel against them plan. Where have your morals gone? X amount of wickedness, them cultivate evil, them farm. Where have your morals gone? Babylon, Jah I go hit you with a storm. Where have your morals gone? X amount of wickedness, them cultivate evil, them farm. Where have your morals gone?
The man said, where are the morals gone? Where are the morals of the people in this land today? Welcome Rico Banton right here on Hot Wax Blazing FM. Everything turn up and of course sit and burn up. Welcome Rico, live on Hot Wax Blazing.
Yes, my general. Enough love and honor to you.
Great stuff. Indeed, today is a beautiful day. You know, before we ask Rico to introduce himself, we're going to be, of course, blessing up our sponsors. KSH Double Alive Communication, this part of the program brought to you by KSH Double Alive Communications. And of course, it is a very special moment having Rico Banton on Hot Wax Blazing FM and Community Scope. This segment is called Rico Talk to the World. Is listening to you right now, Rico Banton. Rico Banton is your correct name, and where are you from?
Well, my birth given name was Dale Hilton, you know. That's my mom's name that she gave me. But when I was a young boy going to primary school, I liked DJing because I loved to listen to Jules the Whale and Charlie Chaplin and them. And then when I grew up, you know, when I was in my teenage years, I started doing songs and stuff like pretending to be Josie Wales and them, you know. And then, I used to go by the name Ricky Culture.
Yes.
See? So in 1985, after doing my thing from like in the late 70s into the 80s, I met Burro Banton. And because my voice sounds somewhat like his voice, the name came up, Rico Banton, you know?
Yes. Wow. So, Rico Banton, you say, was dubbed of another Banton. That's
The original Banton in Jamaica, Burro Banton.
Burro Banton himself. That's the original Burro Banton, indeed. And tell us a little bit about how did it started for you in the music before you reached that stage when you met Burro Banton to give you that name. How did it started for you, your musical journey? Talk to us about that.
Yeah, well, I'm a church kid, so when I started, as I used to go to the Yalas Seventh-day Adventist Church. Yeah, I was born in Kingston, but my family moved to St. Thomas when I was at an early age. So, you know, them couldn't take the city life no more, you know, so they came to the country where they had, my father was fortunate to get some land from his grandmother, so we had somewhere to be at. So I started going to church with my family as a kid, Yalas Church, Adventist, and, you know, I sang in the choir and stuff, you know, and then I went to the Yalas Primary School and I did the same, I sang in the choir, and every little concert the school had, I would be a part of it. That time, my voice never this big still, me used to sing like Michael Jackson, you know. Bend the two of us, listen, bend the two of us, we look no more. We both found what we were looking for. We could friend to call my home. When we are youth, you know,
yes.
So me I try to emulate the voice, you know, it's not gonna work. But, yeah, so it's like the you want, no. So, the session, Yalas is a dance city. Yalas Primary School, back in the days in the 70s and the 80s, when DJ around sound system, if your sound don't come to play in Yalas Primary School, you don't really have a sound.
Yeah.
You understand me? That means it was like a city center for big sound system.
Yes.
So every big sound system come through my town. And because of that now, me start drag. To, even though me I go church, me still love the music. And my father was a radio technician, you know. So him have a sound to himself, a small sound. And he fix everybody's sound around the end. That he was like a leading technician in the whole community in the Yalas area. So, you know, him have a sound, but every other big sound will come around the place, you know, we used to listen to me. I'm a friend named Desi. We live on the same road. You know, a youth named Desmond Hall, big man like me, you know. Even though me I talk like this, me 58 right now, you know. So, me and Desi used to like, listen to the artists, them, and him DJ like Charlie Chaplin, and me DJ like Josie Wales. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then we get a song for DJ now, because we look for a name, Scooter Rankin. God rest him soul. There was a policeman at the station in Yalas who had a song named Super Rock.
Yeah.
And Super Rock never had no selector. So he started just to play the song around the place. And my little friend now draw close to him and start select the song. And through him now, I get the song to select now. We are getting the DJ upon it. I get to practice. But we used to practice on jukebox. Sometimes we used to tie away at the bars. In the jukebox. Sometimes they love for here or there, but sometimes we get man at enough. Them run out of one bar, we end up in another bar. We at the jukebox. See? Yeah. So we get, I get my first coming up in as a DJ. Practicing from jukebox. If the whole of folks know jukebox, the youth them have got research jukebox. You get me a say? But
yes,
every bar in every community had a jukebox. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So we get, I get my practice from the jukebox. And then we had super rock sounds. And then we had another sound now that not, was not really in our community, but it came to our community play all the time. Seeing, and that was Midnight with a soldier who won it named Tombi. Now Tombi a player, Green Sleeve records, some records from England.
Yes.
Some dub were different from the dub them were actually there, Jamaica. Uh-huh. You get me a say? So now, as a youth, now when you are DJ from that, you have to tough.
Yeah.
You have to know if you control your vibe, you have to know how to DJ. You know, like them youth right now, with from this thing, where them are doing the trap, where, and also a lyrical content, and you have to put lyrics after lyrics, and I go on, seeing so, Midnight, was the next song we did when we did DJ fan me, I'm looking for in them. Then we moved from Midnight to a song named Black Emperor, a bigger sound.
Yes.
Seeing
so Black Emperor, Black Emperor and Midnight song. This song was from St. Thomas?
Yeah, man, the two of them are from St. Thomas. In a two adjoining communes them come from. One come from Lyde, yes, and the next one come from Yellows Valley. And me live in a Yala, so me living in the main town. But them are some song with them on the outskirts of my town. Seen, yeah. But them complain on my zone all the while, and then when we get to go ahead now to start DJ Pantombe Zone, and him carry up in a film end now, and we are going to dance all over St. Thomas, Bart, Dalvi, everywhere where the sound, where the sound get up, we're dead, you know what I mean? So it's like, after that now, Junior Reed now, there was some youth, not the singer, but this youth time name a Junior Reed took and people and name Reed. And the owner saw name Black Emperor.
Yeah.
Him and a youth named Azzy. Then Azzy break off now from name Star Wars.
Yes.
So it's like you know me a DJ them three them sound it. And before we get to speed up now, so me a DJ a next song name Concord International come from Gutterhead with a youth with select it. Yeah. I like say yo up now. When me a DJ from Midnight and Emperor, even though Emperor is down, them live in a different zone from we, so them live a Gutterhead at a different end.
Yes.
So me used to just go around a sound like a just DJ funny thing, me just go around and still like that, my friend, and me I try to get a itch from the sound. So me know me never use that sound they carry an import DJ, you know. Them and like the era, them now use era DJ alone, them are import DJ. Anthony Redrow, import Capleton, all of them man they are as youth. Come round, roll away a youth. So me now get so me start going jabby now. Me no lift back, but we take up two wire and that's a mile little thing when me contribute and go up on the sound chuck. For where I go. You and the sound I go together. You know, cause we not no car. And I like them there where you can jump in and car and box and the arms and everything what we got to make that dance that happen in the truck.
And no space now in the front.
Yeah, they might have been going in the front for there. Up on the back sometime all the lights where you each all the artists and throw him off on the truck. We see them things that happen in a real life.
Yes.
You get me answer?
Yes.
So it's like now, thank God now, we there fire, but we now live no back field. We live two wire and thing and where. So one day, you know why they must bring up the sound. Jabby, the selector said, took that sound that they doing by a youth named Glenn and his brother named Bigger Belly.
Yes.
So it's like to know, Jabby said to Glenn, don't you have to listen to our culture, I'm still here, man.
Oh, you know what I'm saying? Your name was culture at that time?
Yeah, man. Yeah, at that time, my younger, before 1985, our culture, I'm in here. So it's like, Jabby said, yo, Glenn, they don't know what's a culture DJ, Ricky culture DJ, and them start laugh, and Glenn will laugh. I said, Ricky culture DJ, all the while him coming on the sound, him never said nothing yet. He said, yeah, man, so Bigger Belly say, Jabby said, yeah, man, that's cool. Another type of youth, you know, you might try to wait for a man game to go ahead. So Glenn said, all right, when the sound sound like? So when the sound string up now, and them tune up the mic and thing, them give me, and then listen to me, like, I got this heart to beat in brain, heart to beat in brain. So, you know, some of come on the thing, you know. So, yeah, right with it, man. All right, here what? When the sound string up, in my one idea, you have to start with that.
Yeah.
So me start dance from Concord. See, them import a whole party to come to. That's why me, right now the artists in my lifetime right now, in this time, yard and abroad, when we're foreign or Jamaica, me not really care if me start the stage show.
As long as you know that you're on the stage show. Where
you yeah, man, fight for that. By your wife, you know my time to start. See? Me used to start in the dance.
Oh.
So when me know me have to start, I'm catching fire. I catch me, I catch fire for the next man, then we have come along.
Yes.
And when you have to make sure, say, you come to deal with that face there and more.
Wow. Very artist. Right now, they think that to close the show, you're a big artist to close the
show. I think you're a big artist when you start the show, because you have to start the fire.
Very interesting.
Even if he's a young artist, as long as he's not a coma artist,
as long as you're not a coma artist.
Yeah, you're going to get identified in the venue.
Yes.
When you walk off of the stage, you're even 10 or 5, yes, you good move. I love that.
Yes.
Right now, me I get a call from one of my dearest friends, Nathan Ellis. I'm going to call him back when we're done this.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's like, yeah, man, so we start DJing, you know, from Kang Bang Kang card. You know, as Mr. Capleton, them a come, Anthony Red Rose a come, whole for artists back in the days. All of them artists from my time a turn up in the dance.
So,
you know what I mean?
So I don't cut your ego. So those dance in the DJ and or somebody else is it?
No, as Mr. earlier, we did that earlier before when we defined Super Rock, the Charlie Chaplin, Josie Wheel lyric. Then we figure out, say, yeah, well, yeah, the people have liked that. So what we have to do now is start. I'm going to show you when we get to my first own lyric device pretty soon. So in a 19, all right, after Concord now, me end up telling you now because out of my community, I'm a zone. Because the artists, they may come from town, come to country, come, yo, you come to town.
Yeah.
See? So now me start from a town. So before me start even getting at the art of the city, me start ends up like, me live in Yala, so we end up at 11 mile first, and me die 11 mile and circulate 11 mile and thing, you know what I mean? Then me a DJ all the town them round that area there. See, then me get up, me end up out of 7 mile Shooter's Hill. See, out of 7 mile now, you have two sound when me used to DJ out there, so now I'm going to get permanent from one of them. That was Terminator sound, live up in a Shooter's Hill from Sam Isaac Road. I have Music Master, live on the main street. A Nazi named Aldi did own it, and his brother named Clive. So me now and Daddy Shaw, Leslie Thunder, you know what I mean? Major One. What power used to DJ that sound there? See? So it's like, you know, one day, you know, we now have no session one weekend.
Yes.
But over the big venue, Poolside Arbor View.
Uh-huh.
Them have a big dance over there. Seen with a bunch of my artists when me a DJ with from town to like Crowty Ranks and Blacker Ranks and Blacker Shine, the whole of them you there.
Yes.
So it's like them they pan a town now named Libertone from Kivali Garden. Libertone now was owned by a man named Egger. So All of my DJ them, you know, Blacker T, the whole of them.
Yes.
Is not different Egger sound.
Yes.
No, over there, so me should have enough because my two of them are over there and there. But you have like maybe 20 man over there. And over the next town, we're in at the venue because two sound are playing. Libertone, seen with Proud Ranking them different. And Tower, owned by Chinese ASEAN and brother them. And only one DJ over there. And the one DJ is more of Anton. So when me I look on it with the ratio, me have the blood vibe. But no one gonna talk my crowd over there, so man. I go hard when you get to my god and a bunch of man rush it. So me now with my brave self. Say yeah, what me I gonna do. I got time for Alboro and beg him attack. He don't know me and me don't know him.
Yes.
We don't hear about him seeing cause, you know, Boro when I stalwart not the game from
yeah, man,
back
he's
in that time.
He's veteran.
See, so you have to hear him. So yeah, hear about him and things. So When I, you know, all the bad rhythm, them are borough bands and sound of page, you know, borough bands and them DJ on certain type of rhythm. Sankai Shek, Darker Shade of Black, Spain, yes. Taxi, Ansa, Spain, them type of rhythm that him a DJ on. Spain, and me a itch up beside him all along now when I say, yo, DJ, me a chat no man. Every time them a play, I want them a play, you know, them play part one. And then them just finish over and play a part two. Yeah, original dancehall, rubber dub style, like where I and I do a caveman sound every Wednesday night now.
Yes.
So it's like, no, we got Dr. Cave and the caveman crew as well.
So this what you're doing now is nothing new.
No, man.
Exactly.
So when we go over there now and go try talk to Boro, we get a chat now. Shankai Shepa, Bad Rhythm. Darker Shade Bar.
Bad rhythm.
Bad rhythm apart. Yes, when answer come up.
Yes.
We start not the DJ recorder, you know, as a general. I say a thing, no man. So him chatting thing and him done. Him say, yo, yeah, you're my people from Nigeria that told you to stop beside me. I want him to say a thing. Look where we are. And when he give me the mic, seeing, yes. When he give me the talk of phone, I said, bless up to the people them, and he look for me good cause. He come like a him attack to himself.
Oh. the same voice that come out of you.
All right. So
weird.
he look for me good. So when they put on the rhythm, that the vineyard part rhythm, boom, 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 boom. And me, I said, man, you're not culture, man. You're a Bantan, man. Stand tonight when you're a Bantan, here.
Jano Star.
From tonight, a Bantan, your name. 1985, that. Poolside Harbor View, Borough Bantan. Me drink Borough Bantan for the first time.
And which song you said? Which song you said that was? Which song was it?
Chinese Azzy song, Star Wars.
Star Wars. So that
come from Harbor View.
That was a song that he was DJing and when you get the name Banton. It was
man.
Him just said Banton, but he never tell us a Rico Banton.
No, we know go back now. We start to know he got down now to the drawing board and said Ricky Banton son Carney. You know? Coming here, Ricky calls. I mean why that's where the Ricky. I mean, I'm looking to what they know for Shooterville. Because for Shooterville, we come up with the name, you know.
Yes.
See?
Uh-huh.
So we're for Shooterville now. We start wonder. What we say? Richie Rich. With Ricky Ricardo. See? He used to be on TV a lot. And a man say, yo, Rico. And a man say, yo, Rico good enough. And I'm going to go Spanish say, yeah, Rico mean rich, you know, DJ.
Oh.
I'm say, yes. Yeah. Rico mean rich. He say, yeah. And Bantan means money will love chat, so I you that. Yeah. So he say, yeah, rich Bantan. But we're not going to say rich Bantan. We're going to say Rico Bantan, like Puerto Rico.
Yeah, Rico Bantan.
Yeah, it's actually R-I-C-O, Rico Bantan.
Yeah, Rico.
Yeah, and I don't intend to change this name. This name was given to me by a stalwart in the game. Seeing a man whom I respect exactly. To the maximum, to the ground of my work band.
Exactly.
That him see me as a peer with him as a young youth. Seeing?
You have to give the man in flowers, man. I love
yeah, man.
That, you know?
Yeah, man. Them, me have no picture of me and Bruno. Kind of time, anywhere I see him, you know, me and him have to stop and take picture and them thing. You know? We have all the memory there. You know?
Yes.
See?
Yes.
Yeah. And you are, see, right now, as it go along, him not too feel well, so the other day when I called, the last call, I called him, I tell him, say, if we even have to carry the studio to his house, to revise a tune together,
yes,
I would like to buy. I would love to write a tune alongside Borough Bantan.
We here at Hot Rocks Blazing FM would endorse that, because that would be a really historical collab, and try your endeavor best to do something like that.
Yeah, man, me work on it, Ken.
Yes,
seeing, and as we say, you see people here, Buto, because one at the time I had left the scene, You know, you're getting some little trouble as a youth and thing, and you live a town, and me live at Kingston 13, Chisholm Avenue and thing, and
yeah,
getting a problem now. So, for me, leave my house from 16 to me love music, you know. And my father and my mother are Adventist. Me up in a, from Friday evening, me can't do no session, but at them time the session has start. So me leave my house and go live my cousin in Tel Aviv, downtown. You get me, I say?
So, you left from St. Thomas and actually come live in Kingston now?
Yeah, man, as a youth. Because we couldn't, my father wanted, my father's a technician, as me say. So he wanted me to fix the radio.
Yes.
My father teach me about diodes, capacitors, transistors, you know what I mean? He's a man who build amplifiers, resistors, tubes. You know, he would get the thematic, cut out the metal casing, cut out the holes them for the tubes, tube amps, put in the connectors for the tubes to push in. And he did all of that by drilling all them holes and the schematics and setting up everything. So my father was a mastermind at that. And then what's he right now? He wanted me to become a radio technician like him.
Oh.
But I wanted to be the man talking on the radio. I never really want to fix the radio because I see my father getting a lot of fracas. No, I'm not telling God truth, son. You see my father getting a lot of fracas with people and take our dinner money, fix to them radio. Things that when them come, them up here and get them radio. And them come and tell him a bunch of BS that he must get mad. And little did they know, my father didn't know the business so much that after 90 days, when a thing stay in him shop, it automatically become theme one.
Oh.
And even if him not sell it, you know him do? He's a man where in him mad state at the same by him barn, crazy as hell. Him just threw it all over the gate for you and just broke it in at the street, and you have to just go. When you go to the station and him go to court, you can't win back because the thing was ill. 90 days had passed and you have not come to collect it.
Oh, him know the law. Him go by rules.
And that is what me I tell all these little young cats right now, what say them are bad people. When you're going to do something, you got to study the draft board first. You got to know
what
you're going into, what it entails.
Exactly.
What are the punishments if you were not in the right? And what are the highlights if you're in the right? You get me, I say?
This talk is very interesting, chit chat right here with Rico Banton. In case you just join us, you're in tune to Hot Rocks Blazing FM. And of course, we're chatting with Rico Banton, the original Rico Banton that got the Banton name from the original dancehall veteran, Buro Banton. Indeed, he's here with us today. And I must ask this question, your dad is still alive?
My pop passed away 30-something years ago, man.
Oh, a very good time, a very good while. We're going to be taking a small break, a musical break, to listen to one of your songs. And when we come forward, we're going to be talking about, of course, your recording. Because from the sound system, and how did it start before you to start do recording your songs? Very interesting, very historical moment right here on Hot Rocks Blazing FM, talking to Rico, the original Rico Banton, right here on Hot Rocks Blazing FM. Take a musical break, about 1 minute or so, and we come right back to Rico.
Remember the days of Marcus Martin, Bob and Peter Tosh. When the morals them portray, we used to embrace. Some of seem like the leaders of the world really lose them touch.
Call them in at them power struggle and them vanity rush. Rasta now get mixed up in at them dirty kind of life. Me a feel live good with me, kiss me empress, she and me wife. Live good with me neighbors now, live in a strife. Cause Jah and me creator, we live a moral life. Me say where have your morals gone? X amount of wickedness, them cultivate evil, them farm. Where have your morals gone?
This is a song from Rico Bunton, Where Are Your Morals Gone?
I go hit you with a storm. Where have your morals gone? X amount of wickedness, them come. Religion, burn Hollywood, now she put in what it congregation. X to them, I go morrow, them I go burn them and say one by one. Cause them strip from righteousness and cling to what's wrong. Them read the Bible, the Quran, them know them feel live clean. But them I live real, dirty with them immorals. I'm married, no queen, and I mislead the youth who young, fresh and green. Where have your morals gone?
Yes, indeed, a beautiful song, of course, from Rico Bunton. Rico Bunton, on the second segment, we're going to be talking, of course, in the synapse to the recording system. Talk to us about that and a little bit about this song. What inspired you to write this song before we go there?
When I was living in America when I wrote that song.
Yeah.
And what I noticed was segments of what was happening while Obama was going to be inaugurated as the president. He changed from a man that says monogamy to a man that says otherwise. And we would say anything or do anything just a game or when the people had you at heart and was looking at you, people like me, because many people still went to them and they kept him as president for two seasons. But when a man like me looked at what he said at his in his first when he was just campaigning,
yeah,
and what he actually came and did was far different, and I'm talking in lots of different ways. Like he changed the I don't like to talk about those people, but if you know what I'm talking, he accepted them and you know what I mean?
Yes,
he accepted what he had came up with first because yes. of the powers that be that he actually worked for.
Yes.
Because of that, now I saw him change his moralistic ways to be a man that, you know?
Yes.
accepted things that we would normally accept.
Exactly.
When it comes,
yes.
Yeah, but I don't really like to speak on the issue of those people because I'm not. I like after that now, and that song, and then I look at Jamaica too, the diaspora, and I was reading up on the, what you know, and I was seeing a lot of things that was not right, you know. They would say they were curtailing, making sure they kept profanity out of the stage shows and all them things. But when you take it out, it was just a start. They arrested some artists, they let some slide, and it was like a pick on you type of thing. It wasn't really something that they were wholeheartedly doing to curtail and keep dancehall and rubber-dub clean.
Yeah.
You get me, I say?
Yeah.
Them never, that was the moralistic part of it. Other than that, no, how I got into the feud. All right, so after talking that song alongside Burrow,
yeah,
and getting some forward in the session and talk other songs to and get forward and feel good now.
Yeah.
No, my friend, no, well, you're ready for the studio now, you know, cause a big time this now, you know.
Yeah.
Right? So, yeah, a big, you know, against a soldier down in a Tel Aviv, we have a sound named Chief. See? So me and Country Speng, and what do you tell that name? The DJ, DJ the other name that died lately. That he was old DJ, we just bust out of the park as a old youth. Yeah, name. But then with Country Speng, and that mean we must. Tiny girl, are Amari, are one of them. Gullibop.
Oh, Gullibop. Oh.
We know him as Country Speng. Yeah, when him just come from country and run with. So me, Louis Culture, we in the ranking, Peter Crown, you hear me, I say? Country Speng, whether you tell him, his mother used to have a bar at Gold Street. So even when they are Gold Street, and that's the opposite of what is happening, we him have to come at Tel Aviv to we. But that's what the sound there. You get me? I say, so me they just know one, you know me, I get highlighted in the Kingston now, and someone now abroad hear about me and see me, and the man them know what someone will actually know my people. They, you know, I didn't know them. Yeah. But the people and thing, and it's like say, okay, when they came, somebody introduced me to them. They were say they were going to do some songs. So in 86 now, the 8th of June 1986, I went to Top Gang Recording Studio for the first time. Seeing, and this was the producer, GT, that took me to the studio. And, you know, now he had heard me on The Answer, so he made a remake of The Answer for the song I just told you I did, I grew up on the music loving. I just re-recorded that song right now in 2024. And I'm going, he remade that beat, and that's The Answer with him, Vineyard Party. And I went in and I voiced three songs that night. But before, when the talk, back in the day, they used to have a talk that said dance and studio are not the same. So on the track, when you go in a studio, You have to do different. You have to know timing. You have to know the beat of the bar. You have to know bridge. You have to know the change, the tone up and the melodies and all them things. So when now we're going out the studio for the first time, coming out of church now, it teaches them things. It teaches about beats of the bars and all that. So we sing from a hymnal with stanzas and choruses and all them things. So you hear me what I say?
Yeah.
So it's like, when we voice the first song, when we go down and go back round in front of, that time they mute the Kelly them, the two Kelly them. And them used to do down at Top Gang at the time. And them, Not that the Kelly them will end up going work with Jeremy and a Penthouse. See? So, I them take my voice, and when we come out of the booth and go around there and them are listening back, they must have DJ. That's who nobody know, but you have to go back and voice it, you know. Ken, I'm a first time in a studio. And in my voice, I voice the tune, enough voice, and bad trembling, I hear every tremble.
Yeah, you're nervous. You was a little bit nervous.
Yeah, you can't hear every tremble. What the heck? Nobody know. But you have to go back and voice it. Because listen here, you can't hear me a tremble. You can't hear me. Yeah. You know? So, them tell me to drink some water. And them give me this idea now to start splash water for myself as a ritual before me go around the microphone. Me just splash water all over my body.
Oh.
You get me, I say?
Yeah,
all over my head and things, just splash water. And that keep me kind of calm me down and cool me. Yeah. And it became something that I did after that night on a norm. I don't do it no more because my seeds now. But when you did young, you need something to, as a mantra, something to go to. And that was my go-to. I didn't drink, right? And I didn't smoke at that time. See, I had no drink or smoke to calm me down. I'm on the phone. And I'm not
sorry, he didn't smoke at all. He was idle.
Yeah, so I was natural. And all my artists tell me to want to own me in church.
Yes.
So it's not like, say, even though all the years have passed, me still have keep certain moralistic way when me learn inside that they got. You get me what I say?
Yes.
So, me go buy the song one, and fight it back, and it sound good now, and them to them at the same time. I'm going to buy three songs tonight. I'm going to buy Music Loving, Decent Living, yes, and see?
So,
and,
go ahead.
Yeah, the man them know, me Music Loving and all them things there. You get me, I say?
Yeah.
And, no, me that Jamaica, we say, my producer gone back to California, so me that Jamaica, we say, thing, and me I hype like hell at Jamaica, because me have tune where I have play for RGR and things, so me need, not them a play the tune for RGR and things, so me feel good, and me I get interview and them thing there.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I hear nothing from the soldier them.
3 years.
3 years.
Wow, that's a
so in the 4th year, in the 4th year now, my cousin from California, he had moved to California. So one day, him come here, you know, and I drive past, and I rent a car, you know, one thing, you know, because he grew up amongst up on the block, so him there my house all the time. So him stop on my foot, me walk with my and Junior.
Yeah.
And the man stop my chair, put him to Rico Banton. He said, Wagwan General. Wagwan Baga. He said, where you car there? Mr. Hey. Car. He said, yeah, man, where you car there?
What him say, where is your car? Oh. Why is he asking you where is your car?
Because me a DJ, and then this,
yes.
My song, Music Loving, in 1987 it released, into 88, was on the top reggae chart.
Oh, wow.
So because of that, now them must say, me supposed to have money.
Yes.
Me supposed to drive car.
Yes.
See? And at that, he said to me, where you care? So I said, I don't care. So I said, you tuned up on the LA chart, you know, top 10 at the LA chart, you know. Oh, you know, I drive no care. I mean, I make him know the boy, the man, them, no come back from a bike to tune me, I hear nothing from them at the 14. So it's like, say, me now say, all right, me now about to wait from them. But you know, it was like a faithful. You know, say, when you have somebody, I'm a first, remember, it's like my first experience going into the studio. So me know, me have said them money, and me have pledged my allegiance to them in the music business. See, now them produce me first.
Yes.
See, so anything at them me I work with.
Yes.
I me never really go do anything else. Me have the sound system. Cause that's why I become, me just love the sound thing for a long time. So me go and stick to the sound. So it's like some, I don't know, me I work as a security officer. But when the security firm have anything, me hold the mic and tear up the place.
Yes.
So what, the accountant, one of the accountants at the security firm had a label.
Yes.
And he introduced a Bill Feem reading them, and a common man, a Chalice and Firehouse crew, and them, and they Bill Feem reading them.
Yes.
So he must say, I must spend money. So he must say, yeah, what? Come buy it from a label, rare. So I buy it from the label now. He start giving me some prime time and interview for RGR from Friday evening time. They used to have a Friday evening people on RGR interview them and stuff and play them songs. So me get from that like twice.
Yes.
To this man, this new producer.
So when do your voice find?
Oh, my voice, I sound name. Don't bother with your papa line. Don't bother with something because you with that behind the line. Don't bother with something because you with your papa the line. I'm going to say, ring a roses, dance for the poses. I saw my son watch the girls fall down. What the girl in my butterfly? I'm a rocking the list. We say we're in the town. I'm in the you know, yeah, so me I get in. Me I do music video for that and thing. The interviewer asked me what happened to my previous. In years, I made it a previous producer.
Yes.
I mean, a previous song, so I'm to my previous producer. So me, I say, you all know, say, boy, General, 5 years, no, me no hear nothing from them, man, you know. The man, them go away and tell me, say, in them up, me a little piece of food.
Yes.
And tell me, just hold that, because them a come back. And the man, them no come back. That's our family. Call him a foreign. I'll hear the radio program.
Yes.
And call this man a foreign and tell him, but me no know that. Jamaica, no one send one of my little artist friend named Shambaru for me.
Yes.
And Shambaru, them know say them send Shambaru man, yes. A my little singer.
Yes. Say like, that.
Yeah. So when them send Shambaru for me now, and Shambaru come, cause him don't know where I go on. So him come and I say, boy, your producer coming and him say, boy, my money for you, no, really, come check him. So me now go with him and go check the producer, sit down there, eat some liquor and thing. Them time you know me, I smoke some weed and thing.
Yes.
So it's like, we did a feel good 2 hours or more halfway. And the club said that a man come call me. And when they come call me, them call me in our room, I'm going to our room. The man them joke me and say me a tarnish his name.
Uh-uh.
Oh me fear call up his name, right. General. Oh me spread dirt for your name and the man them beat me up at gunfight, you know. And when the man uncle, cause them know my family, you know.
Yes.
See? And like his uncle said to him, say, yo. You can't kill Charlton boy. You can't kill Charlton boy because I wanna wrong him.
Yes.
So I let him go. You know what the man them do? Call police. Tear the police some money.
Yes.
See? The police, you know, some killers, you know. Yeah. But here what happened now? Me and the police youth club are yalla. And the man, knew the way them tell them in the house and nothing will go on. So the police, them handcuffed me, put me in the jeep. And when they handcuffed me and put me in the jeep, and the jeep drive away with me now. When the jeep drive away with me, them said, DJ. Them, one of them said, pull the handcuff off of me. And when he tell the next one to pull the handcuff off of me, because them call the cap food up at the house now. He said, pull the handcuff off of him. And he pull the handcuff off of him. He said, DJ, what really happened for the house? He said, General. When I know me a DJ and the money, I'm a producer, and I do some tune for him and the man to come give me some money. And instead of giving me money, man, and call me and beat me. And tell and then tell him, I said, me come to rob them.
See?
That man, they tell him, beat me and then give the money, my money, and tell him, me come to rob them, you know, and the psychs, you know. See? Yeah. So the man now, the police said to me, say, yeah, what? Go back a town. Cause I didn't tell them to leave a town and then I come at St. Thomas. Cause St. Thomas is still my ground.
Yes.
See? The man say, yo, the man let come in at the town of Yalas and let me out of the jeep and say, go back a town.
Yes.
And don't go back near them, man.
Ah. Wow.
See?
Wow.
So I get my ass kicked on top of my first three tunes. So me know, that's where it go. All right. So I stop become, me nobody, after that producer, they, and the next producer, Eve Flair, them the name Eve Flair, the next person them the name C-O-N-C-B-G. After them, and thing, me never get nothing to lose. That concept now, him by himself, new car, and me are the artist, and me are your top feature artist. We are going to take photo shooting and so spread. You know what I'm saying? No joke thing when artists are do them thing there. Artists are moved. See?
Yes.
And The man, see me have youth. Every time I come take him, I will cheer my youth, you know. Because me have youth, I walk. And me have youth, me have baby mother, three baby mothers pregnant one time. I got 12 kids. My baby is 22 years old.
The smallest one is 22.
Yeah, the smallest youth when we go to my back at 22 years old, general. See?
So how much kids you say now they got?
12, six daughters. Six
done. Wow.
So I and I have your money. So the producer now, Eve Flair, one of them Jamaica beauty contestants as my manager.
Yes.
But the money, me not see no money come to me. Every mother in class, you know me, him and she.
You see, this is a very good illustration, you know, for young artists out there to see that because of a lot of dealers and producers not being able to groom the artists properly and to deal with artists properly, of course, lost a lot of stuff. And of course, you see, as Rico Banton has explained to you, you know, why you have been so upfront for so long, because of these things, to look at just sticking to the sound system and getting money from the sound system. That's it. Talk to us.
Yeah, man. Because if I'm not sound tonight, I'm not waiting tomorrow to collect.
Yes.
But I pay me tonight, I'm going to go home. Look, I have food for my youth, them different. I can drop off something, I have to drop off something there. So I have youth at Waterhouse, I have youth at Greenwich Farm, I have youth at Grandspin. You get me what I'm saying?
Yes.
I have youth all over. So I have drop off things all over the place. So I can't have nothing to drop off. You get me what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So me just rather the DJ for the sound, because that's it. I'm not going to wait for the producer to sell no song so I get no money.
Yes.
You get me what I'm saying? So me never had a DJ in the studio. After a while, me ended up at, after all that and said, I ended up at Youth Man Promotion, Sugar Miner.
Yes.
See, did actually taught me a lot of what I never really did know about music and the system.
Yes.
See? And he voiced sometimes, I got hold of them right now because his brother has sent them to me, the mix songs.
Yes.
So it's like, He actually taught me the office segment. He see me as an artist.
Yeah,
but the intelligence for me, I was like much different from the youth them from young and jungle around him all the while and them thing there.
Yes.
You get me? Yeah. So he had me in the office to do the business. When fashion them was like a girl and them thing there, yes. them I run up and down with my, you see, come my youth them at over the studio. That was my yard. Robert Christen was my yard.
Oh.
Yeah, God, we live on a jungle. seen me live around a Greenwich Road, and every day me there a sugar miner.
Yes. You know what I mean? And it's very interesting, Rico. It is very interesting to see that in those days the sound system ain't able to promote in the artists and sustain them financially. So in this time now we don't have that. And I think because of management and the producers have not dealt with you in a financial way, you have to turn to the sound system. Although it's not so turning to it because that is your roots. But you're
that is exactly where I come from.
Exactly,
you know what I mean?
Easily and financially beneficial immediately. So you stick to that more than and stick to the recording aspects and of the business. And that hold back your career a lot. So
right,
that is one of the main reasons why a lot of people don't hear Rico Banton as a big name out there, because Rico has some big songs.
And that me just have to tell you, that not just what they say, because of that now,
exactly.
that led to me not being recognized the way I'm supposed to be recognized.
Right.
You get me? I say, because after a while, and the reducers them broke my heart so much time as a soldier, where me no want to do no bad thing, but beat me up over my one. That mean you turn me like you. You want me to be the thing where you want me to be.
Yeah.
You get me?
Yeah.
I'm moral general. But grew up in the church where the basic moralistic part of life, me gain it family. Yeah. Until me grow up as a man now and start ascertaining what is wrong and right in my sight and start doing me a do. You get me?
Yeah.
I say? Seeing? But them really damn put a damp upon me and my career
in that way.
Because my producer way, him a buy himself a car, and him a tell me say he want to buy me a scooter. But him see me a walk with that 3-4 kids. So when you buy me a scooter, general?
A scooter and buy can't carry a new kids. Car. You're a family man, so scooter can't carry.
So me and him relationship, just as an artist to producer, done.
Wow.
It's a big 229 windscreen now.
You see right now, you know, this little chit chat between us right here, commenting for persons and the artists out there who's listening to this. And this is gonna carry on to persons have to go back to listen to this interview. And of course we have to wrap. We have about 5 minutes to go. We have to move on to how did you get in contact with Caveman? In a little nutshell, can you talk to us about that?
Caveman original, you know. When we did a sugar mine, anytime when I have nothing to do a sugar mine at youth man promotions around a Robert Christian, we would all walk up there. Sometimes when I didn't take no taxi, I drive. We just walk from Kentuck and go out Grove Road. You get me what I say?
Yes.
So apartheid thing. We never was. As me tell Doc the other day, me used to come there and to the rat race, me just hang on and watch. Me not get in a rat race.
Yeah.
Me have a ignorant vibe about me, so, you know, me no want, me and you have no contention over my car. Me tell you or the microphone thing. Me and you stop here, so no one good. But once you go on the microphone, things change.
Oh.
Different situation. Mm-hmm. So me used to just say, yo, I'm going to lay back and easy. So when I came back now from the Americas, seeing I was in the Americas for close to 19, 20 years. So when I came back from the Americas now, my friend Lincoln Traffic called me and said, Rico Band, well, he said, you see your kind of vibe. Two people at Jamaica, I work with it now. Seeing Daddy, you go stop beside Liquor Twist, General Tree, and Charlie them. Seeing God, you are not dead anymore, so you have to go stomp, around them. Or Caveman. And Caveman, as you know, was bring a lot of the artists, the Sizzler, the you know what I mean?
Yeah.
The Turbulence, the Anthony B, the, you know what I mean? Young rap, was Caveman, because Caveman was the rap that Judah.
Yeah.
Seeing big up Panhead. Yeah, we're gone and left for a long time, because Caveman and Panhead was close brother in the days when we was young, you were tough.
Yeah.
Seeing? But as I say now, when they get back here and thing, I'm not DJ, I watch the music. I watch all the youth them have it and watch all the big man them lay back and they bring it back to a level of sanity. So My friend Reagan, them a keep a thing, them a Nazi thing a keep him thing, J.A. style choosers and Reagan and steady now. Here's some of that Jamaica, nah DJ, just there up from out of Yalas and send for me. We go on Nazi King, get a good reception and from there so it starts. Big up steady rank, Reagan, out of Bolivia there, yeah, 8 Mile. And then big up Dr. Cave, Caveman car, him up respect. And saying, right now, we are on the Rubber Dub Yard, Caveman Rubber Dub Yard, 13B Ripon Road. Every Wednesday night, host the RT. Big up Teller. Seeing? Big up Teller, IDs, I, Proverbs. Seeing? Big up Apache Scratchy. Seeing? Big up Isa, Larry Culture. Seeing? Yeah, man. And that's just the bottom line. Dr. C, chop it up, clean out, not dust you up. You know, Rico Banton, say that.
Real deal. And of course, Rico, we really have to, because there's a lot more to talk about your care, the musical journey. And of course, where it's at now, and of course, where you're looking forward for the future. And we're going to continue this as part two, of course, coming up on Jamaica Spotlight Show. So we're going to be giving you the date for that one coming up sometime this month. Of course, Rico Banton. Of course, you have a lot of stuff to teach the youngsters. And of course, look out for Rico Banton, you know, because a whole heap of bag of tune the man out, man, may I tell you.
Mr. P and Roddy. Big up Mr. P and Roddy, to part of the family, you hear that?
Yes,
they have a whole heap of song, right? And Shelley Lightning out of London.
Yeah.
And that track is produced by Caveman. You can get it on our leading platform.
Uh-huh.
Rico Banton, Shelley Lightning. Speak softly.
Yeah.
I have another song right now, on the answer rhythm, as I said, I revoiced Music Loving.
Yeah.
Revamped it. Something. So, you know, that is on the drawing board to be released at the moment too. You know what I mean? I just voiced a song on Abijah's label. So, you know, I'm waiting for that song to be released too. I just in England, June P, East London, you know, waiting on them to drop those two. Because, you know, Rico Banton is here. And rather say I wasn't writing songs back then if I wasn't collecting.
Yes.
And I'm still not doing it today.
Exactly.
So, you know what I mean? Respect to all people out there who have been listening. And, you know, for dog place, you can call me 876-471-3 give man studio and things. We're there. Rico Banton.
Your social media platforms, how could I find you on the social media?
You can find me on The Real Rico Banton TikTok. Or Rico Banton. Rico E-A-R Banton TikTok. Rico E-A-R Banton Facebook. You have Dale Rico Banton Hilton Facebook and Instagram.
All right. Bless up. Anybody you like to bless up so far that you haven't blessed up already?
Yeah, man, big up my wife, crazy people, and she cope with me a lot, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, big up my wife, Marcia. Big up my youth, them. My sons and my daughters. Big up my baby mothers, them. The mothers. Because them, they have been good, too.
And none,
so big up the family.
Yes. None of your youth, none of your youth seems to be DJ or singers.
Yeah, man, we have a son named COMPACK, Compact Music, Waterhouse. But same type of tune, them tune I have nowadays. And, you know, sometimes I try to tell him to change him rhetoric. I'm as a father, when I see me talk, you know. So I say, all right, son, go and do that in the radio. We have a daughter, Shandal Empire, or Chantel Hilton, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, man.
Wow. Thanks much, Rico Banton, and of course you're a legend in the thing, and historically, of course you're Justin about the music and where it's coming from the church to the sound system, and you're shining bright like the sun, and of course looking to take over the world with a lot of songs, a lot of remixes, and a lot of brand new songs coming up. For Rico Banton, we're gonna be taking you out of the session with the song from Rico Banton.
All right. Apologize to all.
No,
when Babylon rang them wrong, we have no apology. We not apologize for nothing.
This is no apology. This one them get to ology for all the people them who are keeper from the cemetery. Babbling them a try fi see if them food a conquer with them lock we in a prison. I try fi teach with them philosophy. This is no apology. This one them get to ology for all the strugglers who are keeper from the cemetery. Babbling a try fi see if them food a conquer with them lock we in a prison. I try fi teach with them philosophy. People out there who grew up in the streets without no one to care. Who the system screw from early with
out
them
of many, there's only one radio station that keeps the fire blazing, and it's got to be like no other than King Solomon himself.
We don't have no apology. We don't apology. This one them get to allergy for all the people them who are keeping from the cemetery. From the people I try to see, if them food have come back with them philosophy. This is no apology. This one them get to allergy for all the strugglers who are keeping from the cemetery. Babylon I try to see, if them food have conquer with them lock we in a prison. I try to teach you them philosophy. For all my struggling people out there who grew up in the streets without proof from early with them drugs and beer and guns and ammunition. And them supply year to year. Politicians win election, but them don't seem to die by clothes to wear. If the elders in the hood can afford medical care,
I'm listening to the radio. I only listen to Hot Wax Live with Ken Solomon. Motivated. There are so many radio stations, but only one Hot Wax Live. It educates, inspires, motivates, and entertains you so much.
When Babylon rang them wrong, we have got poor people under too much tight restrictions. We don't have no apology. We don't apologize for nothing. This is no apology. This one them get to ology for all the people them who are keeper from the cemetery. Babbling them a try fi see if them food a conquer with them lock we in a prison. I try fi teach with them philosophy. This is no apology. This one them get to ology for all the strugglers. Babbling a try fi see if them food a conquer with them lock we in a prison. I try fi teach you them philosophy. For all my struggling people loud out no one to care. Who the system screw from early with them drugs and beer and guns and ammunition them supply year to year. Politicians win election, but them don't seem to care. If we have money to buy food or buy clothes to wear, if the elders in the hood can afford medical care, or the mothers of the youth string up big sound or campaign in the square. Them get we vote election done, them take off like a steer. When they get the grant to build the school them promised last year, but them police come around and terrorize and bring fear. Babylon them greedy, them don't like fish here. Them and them steak come out and we and them bread and we are drink some juice, we expire from last year. We said this is no apology, this one them get to allergy. For all the talk it, babble and them a try to see. If them food a conquer with them lock we in a prison. I try to teach with them philosophy. This is no apology, this one them get to allergy. For all the strugglers who are people from the cemetery. Babble and them a try to see. If them food a conquer with them lock we in a prison. I try to teach with them philosophy. What time they think exactly. Of them listen to it. We have had enough of them don't pressure and them secret. And the way them work one way them pay. Can't support my family. Them sell off everything and screw the economy. The only reason we survive is who we are. And them can't take that wrong way. To survive the poor class of the hustle daily. Sell some farm product working at them factory. Wicked from way. We can't use we car and run no taxi. Politician win election but them don't seem to care. If we have money pay by the illness in the hood can afford medical care. Or the mothers of you can afford proper health care. I say this is no apology. This one drug away a keeper from the cemetery. Babylon them a try fi see. If them food a conquer with them lock we in a prison. I try fi teach with them fill up on them get to allergy. For all the drug away a keeper from the cemetery. Babylon them a try fi see. If them food a conquer with them lock we. Gun is for all my struggling peoples out there who grew up in the streets with hope no one fi care. Who the system screw from early with an ammunition them supply year to year. Politician win election but them don't seem to care. If we have money to buy food or buy clothes to put medical care, all the mothers of the youth can afford proper health care. Them sing up big sound of campaigning at the square. Them get we vote election done, them take off like a spear. When they get the grant to build the school them promised last year, so come around and terrorize and break
fear. I'm listening to the radio. I only listen to Hot Wax Live with Ken Solomon. It fills me with love and keeps me motivated. There are so many radio stations but only one Hot Wax Live. It educates, inspires, motivates, simply the best.
This
is Joe.
This is no apology. No apology.
Father Ken Solomon, be more blessing in this time now than I'm forever. See you. Westmoreland. Let me know. Blazing. Bless them. Yeah.
Bless dear place. Bless up place in FM Oja. Bless dear place. That they heat every day and guide the water they drink. And that all the days of their life, oh Lord, yes. Ethiopia, the land of our fathers, the land where our gods love to be. Gathered, thy children gather to thee, with our green, gold, and red flowing over us, and our hem, with our God and their future before us. Ken Salomon will play this big song. Yes, bless up at Wax Blazing, bless their place. Big up Ken Salomon, Oja, bless their place. Bless the food that they eat every day, and guide the water they drink. And at all the days of their life, oh Lord, at yes, they will get blessing. I know that Blazing FM must get blessing. Host I Jah, bless everything. Whoa.